Hi, I'm Tatum, and welcome to MiniStories, the show where I make minis tell stories, make stories into minis, or just paint minis and tell stories. In last week's video, I shared another story around my original fantasy world. In it, however, I included a few terms that need some more explaining. The Keepers, the Faithless, Valiant Research. There's a lot of things to expand upon and a lot more stories to tell. Now, while I was working on this world, I was also looking for wargames to play and armies to begin collecting. And so, when I came upon the Sylvaneth Range from Games Workshop, I realized some of those models were perfect representations of creatures from my world. I could begin an army that felt truly mine while still working on more content for my world. The Dryads, for example, are exactly what I envisioned the Faithless to be. Wooden zombies, so to speak, roaming around the place looking for victims to turn into more of their undead army. So while I assemble a troop of dryads and get them ready to paint, it's time to share a short story. This one is set in a different era than previous ones, happening 64 years before the world-ending event known as the Tearing. Now it's time to learn a bit more about the Faithless, or as they were called back then, the Lomorien. Kara crouched among the bushes, waiting in silence as she watched the Lomorien passing by. If a single one of them saw her, she would soon be surrounded. She had to go back to camp and inform the others. The creatures were getting closer, restlessly hunting her group. Lady Kid and I had to... The rustling of leaves behind her made Kara jump. She turned around instinctively, dropping her bow as she reached for her dagger. A single Lomorien was standing a few steps behind, searching around the area. Fortunately, the creature hadn't seen her yet. Kara held her breath, hoping the undead monstrosity would just walk away, but it slowly turned, directing its gaze to the trees, the bushes, and to her. The young girl reacted immediately. She lunged at the creature before it could react, stabbing it in the neck and twisting the dagger. Both of them fell to the ground, Kara on top of the now dead Lomorien, but there was no time to relax. A massive shriek filled the air. She had killed one of them. And now, the entire army, even the ones beyond the horizon, knew where she was. Picking up her bow, Kara stood up and began running away. Away from the Lomorien army, but more importantly, away from her camp, from her own people. She couldn't let them find the other survivors. Lady Kid and I had risked her own life over and over again to gather this group, and Kara would not let that go to waste. The young woman felt tears falling down her cheeks as she ran. Afraid of being caught, terrified by the knowledge that she would not get away, and over everything else, sad about never seeing her people again, she ran, determination pushing her every step. She had a chance to lead the horde away from the others. If this was her last day among the living, she would make sure to die, helping those who remained. Now that all the Lomorien are assembled and ready, it's time to paint them. And while I work on the wooden tones, lighting effects, and more, I have another short story to tell, this one set closer to the present, 581 years after the Tearing. Everything happened in a heartbeat, a single Faithless losing the laboratory, three of the researchers screaming as the creature attacked them. Professor Van Ilmar closing the door behind him, trapping the creature, the dead researchers, and his own sister. Andra Ilmar on the other side kept banging on the door, screaming desperately as she watched the creature tearing through the bodies of her dead companions. The other two Faithless, each trapped in a cage in the back of the room, kept shrieking, stretching her arms through the cells. Fortunately, the monstrosities weren't smart enough to open them. The half-human, half-wooden creature lifted its gaze, staring at Anra. Bright blue light came from within the Faithless, making their eyes, mouths, and leaves shine, and projecting an eerie light onto the laboratory. Anra looked around for anything she could use to defend herself, and froze as she saw the bodies of her companions beginning to twitch. A soft light started to shine through the many wounds in their bodies, and their skin became harder, quickly becoming into wood. One of the researchers sat up suddenly, his head twisting to look at Anra with a loud snap. She looked in horror as the face of her former friend lost its shape, becoming a new mindless wanderer. One creature was dangerous, even without a conscience or means of communicating with other Faithless, but once all of her companions finished their transformation, there would be no hope of survival. All she could do now was pray that they never got to escape the laboratory. If they did, the whole city, and maybe the kingdom, would be doomed. And with this, the Faithless, or Lomorien, this world's mindless wooden undead, are ready. Thank you all so much for watching. If you like the minis or the stories behind them, feel free to leave a like and comment below, and subscribe to the channel for more. That's it for today, but there's still a lot more minis to paint and a lot more stories to tell. Take care, and thanks for watching.